seen. So anyway, we're going to talk about those things if we get to, is the world ready? We know the world is really not ready, but I'm more concerned about the body of Christ at this point.
Amen.
So we'll talk about those points. Yeah. And you can use your scripture, whatever comes to mind. You can cut in. You know, if I'm talking and something really jumps on you there, just jump in, and then I'll jump back in.
That's right.
It's just a good conversation. Yeah. It's open discussion. Yeah. Everything is open for everybody.
That's right. Everybody. I'm trying to find my scripture here.
Now, I want to go. I'll be reading 1 Timothy chapter 4 and verse 1.
And I got 2 Timothy chapter 3 and verse 1.
All right.
2 Timothy chapter 4.
Yeah, that's
verse
all good
one
stuff.
Through
three. Oh, that's good.
In the last days.
Yep. That's right. Yep. Where's the one when the Bible talking about the elect? You know, when the elect.
If it were possible, even the very elect would be deceived.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll have to look it up for you.
God, I had that in there. That's the one I really want to read. Yeah, but this is a good. We'll deal with that one. Let me go make sure this door locked, and then I'll do the transition. And check on my little man.
Yep, get him comfortable.
Quick question.
Yes, sir.
If you have to cough or clear your throat.
Just like that.
Just turn away from
it. Yeah, just turn away from the mic and do what you got to do.
Okay. Pastor.
Glory to God. Timothy hit this thing pretty strong, and also Peter.
Yes, he did.
Yeah.
Peter talks about not escaping judgment. Right. If Sodom and Gomorrah didn't escape judgment, if Noah's generation didn't escape judgment, if the angels didn't escape judgment, why does this world
think they're going to escape?
God spoke to me this week when I was praying, and I began to speak in tongues, and I interpreted. Mm. I don't know if y'all ever do things like that when you're praying, but I interpreted. God was speaking. I was all by myself. Mm. And the word of God, when it came, was this generation does not believe that I will do what I'm fixing
Calvary
to do.
Calvary Temple, what is it?
Assembly of God.
Assembly of God, where is it? Oh.
Calvary Temple, Assembly of God, Peach Orchard Road, Augusta, okay. Georgia.
Well, I let him do this. I know there's a Calvary Temple, Assembly of God.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Rayford.
Yeah.
So we'll introduce you as Pastor Farmer, Pastor Banks, and then we'll say, you know, tell us where your church is at. Pastor Banks, you have a church now, don't you?
Yes.
You're busy. And so we're going to let you give directions to it. And if you want to, throw your phone number out there.
Yeah.
Because people in the area may be listening, and they may say, hey, that's the church I want to go to. Let me talk to the pastor. So we want to give you several opportunities to do that during our discussion tonight.
Yeah.
Praise.
All right, we got 2 minutes.
2 minutes.
Praise God. Could we, it's too late.
Yeah, could we pray? Yeah.
Go ahead.
Father, we thank you tonight. God, we pray that your people will have ears to hear what we have to say tonight. God, anoint us. God, help us to be sensitive to the Spirit of God. Use us, God. Let us speak as one that has authority that comes from you. Bless every man of God here. God, give us wisdom. Let your people eat tonight.
Touch those people.
Let them be built up tonight, God. Let them know that the hour is growing later and later. The door is about to close. So, God, give us a word to help them see that. Bless these preachers. Bless this radio station.
Yes,
bless Pastor Hall, who constantly talks about the end times. God, continue to give him words of wisdom. Bless this us tonight as we bring forth the word, that your people might be edified and built up. In Jesus' name, amen.
In Jesus, thank
amen.
You.
Amen.
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 All right, brother, what's looking like it over there?
Praise God.
Yeah, let's do it in 5, 4, 3, 2. Hello, everybody, and thanks for joining us on 99.9 WUCC, where you will be hearing the voice of truth. You are now entering our program that starts every Tuesday night at 7 o'clock and goes to 8 o'clock, and that is called In the Last Days. And we try to stay current on programs that are things that are happening around us, programs that are going on that God may or may not be part of. And here tonight, we've got some very special guests in our lineup, thanks to Brother RPI, who's my he's my main second man here.
That's right.
Here, Brother RPI, good to see you tonight.
Good being here today. It's a blessing. Friday night, we had deliverance service at my church at Turning Point Restoration Ministry. It was awesome. I tell you, God really showed up. A lot of people got delivered. A lot of people got free.
I was out of town, you know, the show must go on, and God is still God, and he did some great things. Well, it's good to have Brother Farmer here, Pastor Farmer, good to have you with us on the show. Why don't you tell us a little bit about you, brother?
Hey, man, it's good to be here. I'm Pastor Ray Farmer from Augusta. We pastor at Peach Orchard Road, 3633. Peach Orchard Road in Augusta, right past Tobacco Road. We used to be an old Gracewood building. A lot of people remember the church as Gracewood Baptist, but it's Assembly of God now. We're so glad to be here. We have a big food bank ministry, so if you in need, on every Tuesday between 5 and 7, we feed the hungry. We have a clothing closet ministry, but more than anything, you know, we have church three times a week, Sunday morning, Sunday night, Wednesday night. Yeah. So come out for the word. We love the Lord, and God is so good, and we just want to welcome everybody, and we appreciate the opportunity to be here and to share with the people about the love of Jesus. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Farmer. Thank you for coming. Also, it's good to have Pastor Banks again with us. He's been on the show before. And, brother, it is good to see you again in the house.
Well, good to be back here again with you guys, man. I had such a lovely time the last time I came. We're on 3343 Peach Orchard Road also. Amen. The church, to his former building, that's the building that we got now. So the Lord taught his heart, and we moved in that building almost a year ago. So we just thanking the Lord. We just love to see people saved. That's what it's about.
Amen.
He said, I came to seek, and I know you know that because I hear you on the radio all the time, Pastor Hall. Seek to save those which was lost. That's what we're about, winning the lost. We go on the streets on Friday and Saturday nights. We'll be starting up this, matter of fact, this Saturday, probably about 5 or 6. Anyone wants to go on the streets and give a testimony, but you got to be saved now. My number is 706-284-0864. You can go with us.
Amen. What a wonderful ministry. Brother RPI often talks about Brother Banks and how you got him out there on the streets, and some of his first ministry experiences was on the street. And I thank you for giving this young man a good start. And then God sent him my way, and I'm giving him some training, and he's doing a great job for God, and I really love and appreciate RPI. So, Brother RPI, thank you for bringing this wonderful set of gentlemen here, this wonderful host that we have.
It's a blessing, man. Even Elder Banks got involved in our delivery service. He was over there. We grabbed him, and we had to get all we can Friday night. It was a blessing. But I thank God for these great men, Pastor Ray Farmer and Pastor Elder Banks, coming today. We need more pastors like them, like you, Pastor Steve.
And it's good to have Minister Steve now. We can't forget the man.
We ain't going to forget now. Cause
at the soundboard over
here. That's right. Minister Steve, believe it or not, y'all, he is teaching us how to do the sign. But every day he finds something new, and I be feeling bad because I thought I was the young one learning everything, and now he took the spot, and he just showing me all up. Sometimes I text him, hey, brother, what's the password? And he come right back. There you go, bro. I said, thank you. And first thing he said, no problem.
So, Brother Steve.
No, yeah, it's always a blessing to help out RPI with this stuff, and it's a blessing when I came just learning all this stuff.
That's right.
It's always been a great nudge for me in my life to really look for God and worship God, and it's great being on here and talking about God on the radio.
Amen. And also, don't forget that on Saturday night, y'all have the Hispanic show here.
All right.
Every Saturday night, starting at 6 o'clock.
All right.
Yes, sir. We have the En los Últimos Días, which is in the last days.
Yeah.
Right. Amen.
Mm. They take care of the Spanish broadcast because I don't speak Spanish very well.
No. All I can say is see.
Yeah.
Or taco.
So, So, Brother Steve, did you pick out a song for us tonight?
Yeah, we're going to listen to Matthew West do something.
Well, hey, that's one of our favorites.
Brother Steve, tell us how they can listen to us and all that good stuff.
Yeah, well, you can, if you're listening on the radio, you can watch us in the studio, and you can go to Ustream.tv, and you can just type in WCC, and you can just click it, and you'll see us all sitting in here talking. You can also go to our page, CWChrist.com, and if you go towards the middle of the page, you'll see the broadcast of what we're doing in here. Also, if you go to the bottom, you can go to go listen, and you can listen to us live on the internet.
So, wow, yeah. That's a lot of ways.
Yes. Amen.
Right. Yeah.
Get the gospel out there. All right, let's hear this song. Praise God.
Trouble now, I thought, how do we ever get so far down, and how's it ever gonna turn around? So I turned my eyes to heaven. I thought, God, why don't you do something? Well, I just couldn't bear the thought of people living in poverty,
children sold into slavery. The thought disgusted me, so I shook my fist at heaven. I said, God, why don't you do something? He said, I did. Yeah. I created you. If not us, then
and you know, all of these guys at this table, they do something.
That's right. Each one of them do something.
We're not hearers only, but we are doers of the work.
Amen.
And it's not those who hear, but it's those that are obedient to the word that are blessed. So I thank God for those that are gathered at the table. So I'm going to take the first scripture. Now, we talked about in the last days and the question that we're throwing out, first of all, to our panel tonight is the church ready? Make the statement, Jesus is coming.
That's right.
And then the question, is the bride ready? We know the parable, there were five wise virgins. There was five foolish virgins. Mm-hmm. Well, when the cry came, behold, the groom cometh. Well, guess what? Five of them didn't get to go in because they didn't have the oil.
That's
the truth. Weren't prepared. Mm-hmm. And I'm thinking in my heart that Jesus didn't just say that to be telling a good story, but he told that story to tell us how it would be when he came. That there would be many who were waiting in the church.
All right.
But when the door opened for them to enter in, they wasn't getting to go in because they really weren't part of the body of Christ.
Amen.
So I'm going to read 1 Timothy chapter 4 and verse 1, and then I'll get it started. And we'll just throw this thing around however the Lord would lead us tonight. Now the Spirit, that's capital S, means the Spirit of God, expressly says that in the latter time some will depart from the faith, giving heed to deceiving spirits and doctrines of demons, speaking lies and hypocrisy, having their own conscience seared with a hot iron. And it goes on to say they're forbidding to marry and commanding to abstain from foods which God created to be received with thanksgiving by those who believe and know the truth. For every creature of God is good, and nothing is to be refused if it is received with thanksgiving, for it is sanctified by the word of God and prayer. So I go back to that beginning, that the Spirit expressly.
Yes.
And that that is a strong word.
Strong statement.
It's not saying now the Spirit's trying to tell you a little something. It's yelling. The Spirit is yelling this to the church of the last days.
Amen.
That in these last days, many will listen to deceiving, seducing spirits. And he's writing to Timothy about his church.
Yep.
That in the last days, you got to be watching for this.
That's
right. And I believe we are ready to see the coming of Jesus Christ. And I see it in many churches today. There are many churches who will not embrace the full gospel of Jesus Christ.
That's the truth.
So any guys want to pick up on any of that?
Well, you're right. A lot of churches, they want to be just, they want just part of what's going on. Or they just want the blessing part of what's going on.
Everybody and wants
all,
a blessing.
And all they're wanting, all they're doing is just waiting on God, and they're waiting on God. And like you said, you know, we have to do something.
Right.
You know, because when that door opens, nobody's going to go in. You know, you have to be fully committed to whatever God wants you to do, and God wants you to preach the word.
That's right. Don't give no watered down sermons trying to worry about people's feelings, because Jesus didn't. Jesus gave them the truth.
The truth sets people free.
The truth sets people Amen. Free. You know, and it's just like, you know, for example, I'm going to throw Rick Warren out there. I was reading an article that somebody sent me that he was with Elton John. You know, well, we know Elton John is a full-fledged homosexual. He said that. He brought it out, and he shows that. And Rick Warren said to him, it would be funny if we kiss and see what people have to say. Why would you joke like Jesus. That? You know,
that's foolishness.
That's foolishness. And, you know, we know Rick Warren is with the Chrislam, the Christian and Christian. I mean, yep. The Muslim and Islam and Christian together. You know, he got over 20,000 members. Mm-hmm. And the thing is that being deceived, you know, homosexual is the most powerful thing out there right now. Is we at 99.9, we love all homosexuals. You know, despite of what they do, we try to love them, but we give them the truth.
Right.
We're not going to tell you, okay, what you're doing is fine, and you still go to heaven. No, if you don't change your life, you're going to hell. So why would a preacher like that would mess around and play a joke with a guy who's openly homosexual?
Yeah. Well, that is perfect for what I was – you set me up good. I'm going up for the layup. I got the ball in my hand. It's going to be a slam dunk. That was a perfect setup, because it doesn't say in chapter 4, verse 1, that they're leaving the church.
That's right.
What does it say? Some will depart from the faith.
Yep.
Now, they staying in the church.
Yeah. That's right.
They changing the bylaws and the rules and the regulations and taking the word of God and taking a lot of the authority of the word of God out.
Yes.
And the condemnation of sin out, and the blood and the cross out, so they can have a great club. But listen, it says that they will depart from the faith and to give heed to seducing and deceiving spirits and doctrines of demons. Temple. That's exactly what you're talking about. They're not leaving the church. They're infiltrating. And the church, in ignorance, I'm just going to say it mildly because there's other words that come to mind. But in ignorance, they're saying, okay, we got to love and accept all of these people.
That's right.
Love them,
now.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
But accept them as part of the body of Christ. When Christ said there's not going to be a homosexual, it's not even going to be effeminate.
That's right.
That's going to make it in that's heaven. It. Not even liars are going to
that's
make it in
that's
heaven.
That's right.
So ooh, go ahead,
good.
Brother Banks.
Boy, that's good. Dr. Hall. The doctor in the house.
Yeah.
But the scripture also says many in that day going to say, Lord, Lord.
Come on now,
didn't
brother.
Didn't we not prophesy in your name? Didn't we not cast out devils? And you made me think of that. In the church.
Amen.
They're going to be in the church. And they're going to, Lord, we did all these things, but Jesus is going to tell them, look, I never knew you. You never had my spirit.
That's right.
You never knew me. You was in the church, but you was lost. A lot of people not go to church, but they lost.
That's
some
right.
Some of them in the church, they lost. Oh, they think the church going to save them. Or they think water baptism going to save them. Or just because my name on the roll and I clap my hands and do all these things. In that day, you was talking about the five wives and the five fools. The five wives had enough oil.
They had
the Holy Ghost.
That's right. Mm-hmm. Now, come on now.
That's where the oil was. It was in God's spirit.
That's right.
And the five fools, they said, well, we're going to get in now because we've been doing this all the time. Mm-hmm. We've been going to church all the time. So we're going to make it if you come back. And they find out that they couldn't make it off the five wives, or you got to have the Holy Ghost. You got to have God's spirit for yourself. Because the Bible said, the scripture said, if you don't have God's spirit, you're none of mine.
That's Amen. Right.
See, you think you're going to go to heaven because you joined a church.
That's right.
It's not going to happen. You better have a relationship with the King of Kings.
Amen.
And his name is Jesus.
Come on, brother.
It's not Muhammad. It's Jesus.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
It's Jesus. And that's who I hear you guys be lifting up all the time on the radio.
Amen.
Every time I get in my car, I tell my church member, I say, y'all better listen to 99.9. They guys got a word. They got a word in their mouth from God. There ain't no hanky-panky stuff. They got a word. And that's what we need in these last days, a true word from God.
That's
and that
right.
word you preach, yeah. it offends people sometimes. The truth offends. Yeah.
That's right.
But you sure keep preaching the truth.
Amen.
Because the truth
we
is
will.
The only thing going to stand in these last and evil days.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen. But I believe the Bible talks about tares.
Oh,
so
yeah.
So be among careful.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. You know, among the wheat. And
that's
you,
right.
You're always going to have them.
Yes.
You know, it's a crazy thought to think that the devil's not going to show up at your church, you know. God yeah. might not always show up there. There's a lot of churches, I'm sure, that God hadn't walked in a long time. But
yeah.
And you know what I mean, not physically, but you know what I mean about the Lord not being there. The Spirit of the Lord left a long time ago. You know, you can write Ichabod on the thing, but simply
right.
for the fact that you know, listen, we're supposed to love people.
Yes.
We're supposed to care for people.
Yes.
We're supposed to preach the gospel. We're supposed
Come
to stand
now.
Up for what's right,
yeah,
stand up for truth and righteousness. It doesn't have anything to do with hatred. Because, see,
right.
if I truly love you, I'm going to tell you the truth.
There
I'm
going
to
right.
let you
Come
know.
On,
look
right.
around because,
yeah.
you know, as the signs of time, we're seeing in the last days.
Every
the Bible said there'd be perilous times.
That's yeah. right.
Men shall be lovers of themselves, covetousness, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient. We're seeing
yeah.
those things. But the Lord said to be still and know that I'm God. Realize
yes.
that he's coming. Realize that Jesus Christ is coming back to this earth again. And you better be ready. Because, see, that's the thing. That's the thing that we, you know, we tell people all the time, well, God loves you and God does. And
oh,
he does.
Come on,
thank
now, say
thank
that.
God for grace. Thank God
Amen.
For mercy. Thank God for all that. But you know what? The thing about it is God is still a righteous God.
Yes.
God
Amen.
Still judges sin.
That's right.
And yeah. if you wallowing in sin, you won't. Heaven won't be your home.
Amen.
He said, come out from among them and be ye separate, saith the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
You're supposed to walk right and talk right and act right. Hallelujah. I was been studying and reading and God's word. And you know what? If you read the word, the word will speak for itself.
Yeah,
that's right.
Yeah, you ain't got to make, you know, you ain't got to make no apologies for the word of God.
Yeah.
Amen. Listen, I'm not giving you my opinion. Go to the book.
That's right.
Amen.
Check it out for yourself. Go to the book. See what God's word
yes.
says.
And he's got the final say-so on absolutely everything.
That's exactly right.
It's everything. His word that will stand.
Yes.
His
that's,
word. And you know what? If I speak his word, my word will stand.
Amen.
That's
because
right.
it's standing with him.
Yes.
Amen.
It's like when the scripture says we're seated together with Christ in the heavenlies.
Mm.
If I say what he says, it's going to stand. Amen. If I just tell you my opinion, it's like the wind. It can change. But when I tell you God changes not. He's the
Amen.
Same today, yesterday, and forever.
He Amen. Said it won't Hallelujah. Return unto him void.
Amen.
That's
know?
Right.
Amen. But go ahead.
That's good stuff.
I'm just listening. I'm ready to start shouting, man. I don't know about y'all, but it's true. We living in a time where nobody wants to stand up for anything. Nobody wants to stand up for God. Nobody wants to stand up for the relationship of God. You know, you can talk about God all day long. We can talk about how good God is, but when you start walking, then people have a problem with you. When you start walking like Christ and doing the things of Christ, you know, and watching this world crumble, it really hurts me. You know, because there's enough information, there's enough technology, there's enough churches on every corner, there's enough preacher preaching on the TV, there's enough radios that's preaching the word of God, and nobody wants to listen. Everybody has excuse. Well, I'm busy. Well, I'm busy too, but I make time for God. Like I tell them, what if God starts taking your breath every time you don't pray?
Mm.
How long will you live? Some of us drop dead right then and there. At least I have a little bit of breath, but we have to make time for God,
yes.
especially in the last day. And I want to read a scripture here. And it's 2 Thessalonians 2, and it say, now we beseech you, brethren, by the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, and by gathering together unto him, that ye be not soon shaken in mind or be troubled, neither by spirit nor by the word, nor by the letter, or as from us, as that the day of Christ is at hand. Listen to this. Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day ye shall come, except there come a falling away first, and that the man of sin be revealed, the son of prediction, opposing and excel himself above all that is called God.
Yeah.
And that is worshiped, so that he as God sitteth in the temple of God, showing himself that he is a God. Remember ye not that when I was with you, I told you these things.
Amen.
God is telling us that the Antichrist is coming.
Amen.
He giving us signs. He giving us preachers that preaching the truth, that telling us, and we're not doing nothing. All we doing is saying, well, I'm just going to wait, and then when it happens, no, don't wait. Do it now. Prepare yourself. Mm. We got all these false teachers coming out. We got preachers that's telling you it's okay to drink. Now we got preachers that smoke cigarettes. They want to have church in a bar. You know, let's have church in the bar and let them drink. Well, then they don't give them the truth. You know, and we doing this and we saying it's okay. Well, at least they trying. No, trying is telling them the truth. If you don't put that beard on, you're going to mess around and go straight to hell, or you're going to drive and have an accident. One or two, but we don't want to do that.
Praise the Lord.
Yeah, amen.
A lot of Christians are scared.
They're scared
to hurt people's feelings and stuff like that. And like Pastor Banks was saying, is that it becomes routine to Christians. You know, it's Thursday, I guess I got to go to church.
Yeah.
Sunday morning, I guess we got to get up and go to church. And everything just becomes routine. And you, a lot of time when you're working, you know, you get tired of the routine of going to work. You get tired of your job. You get tired of what's going on, and you don't want to work anymore. And that's what happens with Christians.
That's right.
It becomes routine, and they don't have a relationship with God, and they get tired of it.
Yeah.
And they don't want to look for God anymore.
Amen. But that's what 2 Timothy says in chapter 4. It says, I charge thee therefore before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the quick and the dead,
at
his appearing and his kingdom. The Bible said, preach the word, be instant in season and out of season. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with all longsuffering and doctrines. It says, for the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers, having itching ears.
Mm.
And they shall turn away from their ears from the truth, and shall be turned into fables. But watch thou in all things. Endure affliction. Do the work of an evangelist. Make full proof of thy ministry. In other words, he said in the last days, they're going to turn. But we as ministers of the gospel of Jesus Christ, we should never turn. We should never bend, nor should we ever bow. But we stand on the truth of God's word. Because it seems like a lot of times, you know, I think preachers get so caught up because they see so many people going to the left. They say, well, you know, maybe I'm wrong.
Yeah.
Maybe I'm not reading the Bible like I need to read the Bible.
Well, that's good.
But all you got to do is go back to that one scripture that says, broad is the way that leads to destruction.
Come on,
many there be that find it. And so if you're following the crowd, you're probably going in the wrong direction. God bless you. Amen.
Amen.
That is powerful.
Praise the Lord. If you're going with the crowd, you're probably going in the wrong direction.
You are. Amen.
Amen.
Many there be that go in there.
I was thinking about the question he was when he first came on about, is the church ready? Is the church ready? That's is the church really ready? And the scripture says, you know, and I don't believe we're ready, because the church has now begun to look like the world.
Oh yeah,
I know.
We favor too much of the world. Jesus
That's
said,
right.
"Come ye out from among them, be ye separated,"
Amen.
Saith the Lord, "and touch not the unclean thing. Then I'll walk in you. Then I can talk in you. Then I'll be your God, and you'll be my people." And I was this is a scripture, 2 Peter. Third chapter. I don't know if Pastor Hall read this or not. I think it's some kin to it if he didn't.
Go ahead.
He said, knowing this first, that there shall come in the last days scoffers. walking after their own lust. We see that in church now, big time.
Yeah.
People always got angles for coming. A lot of preachers preach for different angles.
That's right.
You know, for, you know, what kind of gain it is for me, you know, what, how much, you know, you hear people talk, how much I'm going to get if I'm coming. They're not doing it for love.
That's right.
See, everything we do for God has to be based on love.
Amen.
When you share
Amen.
Jesus, it's got to be by love.
Amen.
See, he said, because with love and kindness have I drawn him. God so loved the world. So everything we do, if it's based on love, it's legit, and you will get some results from it. And the next verse say, and they say, this way people at, where is the promise of his coming? For since the fathers fell asleep, all things still going on as they were.
That's right.
And I meet people like this all the time. Yep. Man, I done heard my grandmama told me that a long time ago. He ain't got here yet, but I said, he coming.
He's still coming.
He still, that don't make him not come. Well, I don't believe that. That don't make it ain't true because you don't believe.
Yeah.
Jesus is coming. If he ain't coming for you, I know he coming for Brother Banks. Hello, somebody.
Amen.
If y'all get there, Brother Hall, and don't see me there, remember, you're going to be in the wrong place. But I'll be there. Amen.
Amen.
My reservation is already made. Amen. And my heart is fixed. And I think that's a catch with a lot of people. Their hearts ain't really fixed.
Amen.
Jesus told us, you know, you say, you know, watch as well as pray. A lot of Christians don't watch as well as pray. See, mm-hmm. we're not looking for the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we're not looking for his hasty return. But he told us, as you see the day approaching, continue to serve him. Watch. You got to watch as well as pray. I'm looking for the Lord to come any time. But if he don't come, I'm still going to serve him.
Amen.
If you don't come in the next 20 years, I'm still going to be lifting up my head and telling him thank you for saving an old wretch like me. Hello,
praise
somebody.
Lord,
old alcoholic you. Like me.
Amen.
And gave me a place in your kingdom.
That's
hello,
right.
somebody.
Oh,
yeah. And that's what it's about.
Jesus is coming.
Yes.
And if there's one message we're trying to get out on the radio today, is that Jesus is coming. And that question is the church ready?
Mm.
When I look in the book of Revelation, Jesus addresses seven churches. The first church that he addresses is the church at Ephesus. And the analysis of the church at Ephesus is Jesus says, I have something against you.
Come on.
Because you left.
What?
Now, not lost it. Now, if I leave something is one thing,
talk
but if I lose it, it's another. They didn't
Man,
lose it. They left
now.
It.
They left
yeah,
it.
That's right.
They left. They walked away from their first love.
Mm-hmm.
And he says, if you do not repent, there's going to be consequences.
Amen.
And there's a church world today that is not ready for Jesus to come because, like the Ephesians, they have left their love
point.
For God. They're still in church.
Yeah,
they
right.
haven't left church.
So
they left God.
So what about once saved, always saved, Pastor?
Well, you can flush that right on down with a lot of other false doctrine. Because Jesus says, unless you repent.
Come on. That's
repent
what I want you to
means
bring
turn
out.
Back
yeah, that's right.
to what you used to
yeah.
do. Because you didn't turn going the wrong direction.
Yeah.
So they had to repent to get right with God again so that God would not send punishment their way. And
that's
then
right.
you go to the last church. You go to the church of the Laodiceans, and the Laodiceans had Jesus on the outside of the church, and he said, behold, you know, not the Laodiceans, but the Laodiceans had Jesus so far removed from the church that Jesus says, you are so lukewarm, you're so lukewarm
Come on now, break
that I will
down.
Spew you out of my mouth. It's not that you don't have a form of worship, but it's the fact that your heart is not on fire.
Come on.
Woo.
So if the church of Ephesus had lost its first love, and the church at Laodiceans had a cold love or a lukewarm love, God says it doesn't matter. If your love, and that's what Brother Banks said, everything you do, you got to do out of love. If it's not for love of God, if it's for love of self or for love of self-recognition, or I want to sing in the choir, I want my talents to be displayed, whatever you love about church, if it's not Jesus, you'll be punished.
That's right.
Well, that's
you know, oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead, Pastor.
Yeah, you know, that's what he said. He said, I'd rather you be lukewarm. He said, I'd rather you be hot or cold, but
yeah,
be you
right.
lukewarm. He said, I'll spew you from my mouth. But even the Bible says, you know, we hear that all the time about judging people. You know, the church judges. Well, the Bible says, judge not that ye be not judged for whatsoever. But the thing about it, he said, we can be fruit inspectors.
Mm-hmm.
He said, by their fruits you shall know them. Amen.
Yeah,
if you're
right.
an apple tree, you're an apple tree. just plain as it says. But see, that's what he's talking about. He's talking about being lukewarm. In other words, you should either be walking with me or you shouldn't be walking with me, because there's a difference there. If you're saved, people ought to know you saved. I mean, you know, by the lifestyle that you live.
Mm.
And I think, and like I said, in these last days, we're just seeing people just starting to slide away.
Amen.
You know, and they're becoming so worldly, you can't tell them the church from the world.
Oh,
and if you try to give them a word of correction, which the word of God is for reproof,
that.
for correction or instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be thoroughly, fully equipped to do the work. But when we began to rebuke, then their feelings get hurt.
Oh yeah.
That's because they don't have a humble, teachable spirit.
Talk to them.
And me and Minister Steve was talking on our way over here, and I said to him, it's hard to find anybody that comes into the church and gets saved, surrenders their heart to God, that wants to be a disciple and be brought under the discipline and begin to discipline themselves and receive instruction and correction from the man of God who's over the house of God.
That's good.
So until we have a humble, teachable spirit, and until we submit as leadership to God, then we can expect those under us to submit. But there's many of them today that are in church that do not respect and submit to the authority that God has placed over them. And when you read to those seven churches of Asia Minor, the word was given to the seven angels of the churches. And the angel literally means messenger. Messengers. Who is the messenger to the church? He's never been an angel preach at Johnson Church of God. It's always me.
Amen.
Praise and God brother. Gave me the message to give to the people.
Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord.
So when they receive us as the ministers of God and the messengers of God, they receive Christ. But Jesus said, and told his disciples when he sent them out, in whatever town they reject, you shake the dust off you.
Right.
Because in rejecting them, they had rejected Jesus.
That's right.
Amen. But in accepting the gift, which would be the minister, then they accept Jesus. Yes. So if you can't receive, and I'm going back to correction and discipline, because the Bible says in the last days, they will not hearken to these things, but they want their ears and their feelings to be tickled.
Come on.
That's right.
Yeah. But God's not in the tickling business.
That's right.
He's in the saving, sanctifying, preparing, and then putting you into work into his kingdom business.
Amen.
And it's a serious business with God.
That is so powerful.
And we got to stay focused. I mean, don't look at, you know, I know a lot of church look at finance and they look at attendance, you know. And I heard my bishop said, we ain't in the book of Numbers, we in the book of Acts. We trying to preach the gospel.
That's right.
What I'm saying? And if we preach more of the gospel, the people will come. And if they don't come, then that's who God have said in your church to go out and preach the gospel. A lot of times, you know, the church is a place of restoration and the place of teaching. We needed to get like Elder Bates, get out on those streets and share the gospel, which you have done. And Pastor Steve had done, I done. I know Pastor Foreman does because he talks about all the time. Out on the streets and sharing the gospel. There's a lot of people out on the streets that need the word of God.
Yeah.
Amen.
And if we walk past them every day and look at them like we all mad and upset, then they're not getting the word.
Amen.
So it's good that we share. That's why I love street ministry. Street ministry, when I met Elder Banks, that was my heart. I followed that man in every corner, every hole. Even sometimes there'd be areas where they get kind of rough and they act like they want to run us over. But Elder Banks said, this will always show if you're doing it for God or doing it for yourself. And the love I have for being street man, it was from God. It was never for myself because if it was myself, I'd get mad because nobody showed up, and I can leave.
Yeah.
And every time we did it, it's nobody there, but soon he get up there and say, come up and get prayer. People come out the world. I'm like, where do these people come from?
They want a blessing.
They want a blessing. Want a blessing. Amen. So it's good that we share the gospel to the people.
Minister Steve, why don't you open up the phone lines, and if you have a question or comment out there, you can call this number he's going to give you, and we'll entertain your question or comment.
The number is 803-335-3131. 803-335-3131.
Amen.
Amen. So it is good to have in the studio today Pastor Banks.
Amen.
And Pastor Farmer. What a blessed privilege we have to have you guys and to bring your wisdom and your hard labor. Because
right.
There's nothing that gives experience like being out in the field.
Amen.
And where you're ministering at in Augusta, there's a great harvest there.
Yeah. Yes.
But there's great opposition there.
Yes.
Why don't you tell us about some of the opposition that you find there in the streets and that you find coming in your churches to what you're doing?
Well, I can give you a couple of examples. I was in, Old Savannah, right off Old Savannah Road. It's this project. What's that project name? I'm from Florida.
Augusta now. Commons.
Augusta. Not that one, too, but it's one right off of Old Savannah Road going on to Gordon Highway. Anyhow, there's a little project right there. I remember a time when I was setting up to preach and some dope dealers came down the road. And they said, we don't want to hear that so-and-so stuff here. We don't want to hear
it. Yeah.
This is my street. And I heard him coming as I'm testing the mics, you know, testing 1, 2, getting everything set up. And he was walking closer and closer, and I began to sing a song. You know, I began to sing a song that you know, I said, I decided to follow Jesus. That's the song I began to sing. Oh, yeah. I'm trying to ignore him because he got 3-4 guys with him. But I'm actually saying, Lord, now this guy come at me. You know what I mean? I don't know what I'm going to do here.
Yeah.
I might have to punch him out. So I ain't going to let him just kick me to sleep.
Yeah.
But anyhow, as I began to sing that song, and Brother Sid and another brother came up and they grabbed the mics and they began to sing, and we began to worship God, and only him, only that guy was standing there. All other guys had left, and he went somewhere, and I don't know where he went. He went somewhere and cooled out.
Yeah.
But we was able to get the message across. We was able to preach the gospel. Some people came up and got saved, and some folks came and got prayer. But the thing about that, you have to do it based on going back to love. Because one time when I was doing this every weekend in the heat, I'm sweating like I don't know what in that heat.
Oh, yeah.
In the evening time, got people with me. And then you lead them to the Lord, 10, 11 people come up and join hands. You lead, and you come back that Sunday, and nobody come.
That's right.
And nobody come. And this was eating at me. And one day I said, Lord, I ain't going out there no more. Ain't nobody coming to church. I ain't coming to mine. No, I ain't going no more. And the Lord questioned me. He said, who are you doing it for?
That's right.
You and me. Who are you doing it for? And I just broke down and cried.
Man.
And for ever since then, you have to do it based. Whatever you do for God, you got to base it on love.
Amen.
Jesus based everything he had on love for people.
Yeah.
Even he was got ready to go back with the Father, it was a thief there. He said, Lord, I've been a bad man all my life. I'm a total thief. I've been a proven thief.
Ooh,
I done did a whole bunch of stuff that was evil and wrong. He said, when you come in your kingdom, remember, could you take me with you? Jesus said, today, that's today. Grace and mercy.
Amen.
And that's love.
Right. Praise Amen. The Lord.
Today you will be with me in paradise. So today. How far are you
Preacher.
Willing to Amen. Go to help somebody?
Amen.
See,
Preacher.
We got neighbors, right? You know, next door to us. We don't even tell them about Jesus. If the Lord tell you to go 5 miles, it's 5 miles to go tell somebody about me, or go pray for them, or go bring them some sandwiches or something.
Amen.
We want everything right to us. We don't want to make no sacrifices.
Amen.
And see, Jesus sacrificed it all.
Amen.
When a man gave up his life, he done gave up everything he got.
That's right.
He sacrificed totally for us.
Yes,
and
did.
The thing about us as Christians, we got to come out of them little shells and get up and do something.
Amen.
Amen.
See, God will bless you if you're available.
That's right.
He'll give you something to do if you're available.
That's
but
right.
If you want to stay there and come to church and go home, come to church and go home. That's what I preach all the time. Listen, I don't want to know how much you know. Show me what you're doing.
That's
come on
right.
Now.
Bring some folk. I said, if you're going to bring folk to church with you, I'm going to give you the mic and let you. I'm going to give you 20 minutes of my preaching time.
Yeah.
Because
Amen.
I want the church to know what you're doing to get people saved.
That's right.
It's
Amen.
All about salvation.
That's right.
And that's why Amen. God done gave you this about this end time thing, because he finna come.
Amen. Right. He's coming.
Jesus said this. I'm going to stop talking. This is what Jesus
Go
said.
Ahead.
He says, all day long, I have stretched out my hand to
yes.
a disobedient, gainsaying people. All day long, my hand is stretched out to people.
That's right.
Yes,
now,
is.
What are we going to do? Now, he's using us.
Mm-hmm.
He wants to use us. We the people. Once you get saved, you saved. Now
yeah.
you got to go tell somebody else. He said, Peter wouldn't do our strengthen. Go get somebody else.
That's right.
It's about others. It ain't about me no more. About Amen. Me doing my little thing in church. You see what I'm saying?
Amen.
It's about who am I winning? Who am I making an impact on?
Yeah.
See, I want to be an impact player. Yep.
That's right.
Tom Brady, say what you want to say about him. He was an impact player to me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You get Tom Brady get that football, everybody gets scared. Because they know that he's able to take that ball down the field.
That's right.
So they try to hit him and try to discourage him, hit him hard to hurt him and get him out of the game, because their chances of winning are huge. Well, the devil knows if he knock an impact player out, hello somebody.
That's right.
You know, so I want to be an impact player. I want to, when people see me, I want them to see, hey, that's one of them Jesus freaks.
That's right.
That's, that's a Jesus man there. Hello somebody.
That's right.
I want to weigh him like the homosexuals say, they coming out of the closet. Well, us Christians need to get church to say, I'm coming out of the closet. Hello,
Amen.
Somebody. I'm coming out.
Amen.
Everybody else coming out. So I'm coming out. Yeah. I'm a Jesus man. Hello,
That's
somebody.
Right.
That's
so
right.
This is what I think what you're talking about is need for, and we need to get our urgency in our spirits as believers to tell unbelievers Amen. About Jesus, and we also need to prepare ourselves, like the five wives did earlier in the scripture you quoted earlier.
That's right.
God bless. Mm-hmm.
You know,
Brother Farmer?
Oh.
Yeah, you know, that's the thing about it. If you're scared of opposition, you know, it is hard to witness to the world. I went up to everywhere I go, I tell people about Jesus.
Amen.
I ain't ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Don't Don't ask me to pray for you if you coming out of Walmart. I've seen people healed coming out of Walmart. Said, Brother Ray, would you pray for me? Yes, sir. We'll pray anywhere, anyhow.
Yes.
We still have the right in America as an American.
Yes.
If it offends you, I'm sorry, but I am an American. I pay my taxes, and I can stand up and preach, and I can stand up and pray.
Come on now.
I was witnessing to this one guy. Walked up to this guy that nobody wants to witness to. He was tatted all over, and that's just covered up in tattoos. And I went up and started a conversation with him. And, you know, that's what I tell our church all the time. They said, Pastor, how can we witness? Start a conversation.
Yes.
Just start talking to him, you know, about anything. Now. Hey, I noticed you got a fish. Or, hey, I noticed, you know, you got a tattoo of a bluebird on your arm. You know, that you can strike up a conversation.
Yes.
But the main thing is, he told me, he said, I'm an atheist. I don't believe in God. I don't believe there is no God. I shook his hand. I said, man, really? He said, yeah. He said, I thought you was a Christian. I said, I am. I said, I am a Christian. I said, I have never met anybody with as much faith as you claim to have.
Wow.
He said, what are you talking about? I said, because it takes a lot of faith to believe that there is no God.
Yeah.
Mm. You know, you may not believe in my God,
but
it takes a lot of faith to believe there is no God. Because if you can look at the sun, the moon, the stars, universe, the trees, humans, babies, if you can look at all that and say there ain't no God involved, you got more faith than I ever thought about having.
That's it.
But see, it's just simply the fact, like Pastor Banks said, you know, loving people.
That's right.
The Bible said, how can you say you love God whom you haven't seen and hate your brother who you have seen?
That's right.
Said you're lying, the truth ain't in you. If I really love people, I'm going to tell them about God.
Yeah.
I'm going to tell them what the Lord
Amen.
Done
yes.
for me. And I want to say this, and I want to move on and let you other gentlemen talk, but I'm going to tell you something. You know, a lot of people don't witness because they don't know the Word.
That's right.
But see, the thing about it, you may not have much knowledge of the Word, but you can tell people what God done for you.
Amen.
So you can tell him about when I was in the gully.
Come on.
See, God reached back and got me. You can tell him. You can tell him about, hey, you know what? I was blind, but now I see.
Come
Amen.
On now.
Praise the Lord. See, the woman at the well, she didn't know John 3:16, but she said, come see a man.
That's right.
Come see a man that told me everything.
Ooh,
see, that's the thing about it. You don't have to tell people John 3:16 or go into Jeremiah or go into the depths of Revelation.
You want to shout.
But the thing about it is you can go and you say, you know what? I was bound, but now I'm free. I was lost, but Jesus saved me. See, I was a nobody, but God reached down and he got me. Hallelujah. He loved me when I was unlovable. Nobody else in the world loved me, but I knew when he come into my life.
Wow.
He come loved me. And so that's all we got to do
Amen.
To share the gospel.
Amen.
Just tell them what yeah. hey, tell them what he's done for you.
That's right. Testimony.
Tell them what he's done for you. That's where the word comes, because you know what? We're going to reach more people with the truth, because just like we've all heard it before, it's not what you know people care about. It's how much you love them and
yes.
how much love you show them.
Yeah.
They don't care about your knowledge.
That's right.
But they care about the love that you have for them, and that'll show in your testimony.
Yeah, that saying is that people don't care how much you know until they
know how much you care.
Woo. That's right. And that's very true.
But Pastor, I want to say this. I'm going to be through.
Go ahead, brother.
You guys, I'm going to show you something about love. Now, when you guys got this place started,
mm-hmm.
and you know you needed help, you didn't see color based on brother RP.
No.
You just got him because of love.
That's right.
If you wasn't
that's
loving him, you would have said, I'm not going to get this black guy. I'm going to get somebody like me. You see what I'm saying?
Amen.
But love crosses barriers.
That's right.
It don't see color. It goes beyond that.
Amen.
See, when you love God like that, that's what it's about. It's about reaching everybody.
That's right.
And see, people see God in this studio because of that.
And when you look across at the sound, man, look at the Hispanic God
got a
brother
whole,
right here.
Amen.
It reminds you of the 13th chapter of Acts when all the prophets and preachers and black men, Simeon, everybody was there.
Yeah.
Now watch this. God, that's love. See, God see that. See, we went church.
That's right.
And this pastor here, I was in a little small place. Brother Patrick had been there whole 45 people. And he was across the street in this big church. And God showed them and blessed them with a mega church down here on Peach Archer Road, okay? And he came to me and said, God told me, you're supposed to have this church.
Uh-huh. Wow.
That's love.
Amen.
See, he had a bunch of people wanting that church.
Yeah.
Black and white.
Yeah.
Now, if, you know what I'm saying? When you love people like Jesus, it breaks beyond barrier. You want to do what God say do. That's what you did when you had him. You want to do, you want to please God. Yeah. And that's what it's about with us. We want to please God. Amen. God don't see color. He passes all that.
Amen. Mm-hmm. And that's the thing. What you see right here is just a little bit of what the church is to look
should
like.
Look like. Amen.
That's right. Black,
amen.
White, green, yellow.
Amen.
That's Hispanic.
Hispanic.
You know,
amen.
Chinese, Japanese.
Yeah, that's right.
Blackanese, whatever you want to say. You know, whatever you want to say, you know. For God so loved the world.
That's it.
Totally.
The world.
Gave his
own
that's right.
And I say it, and I'm going to say it again 100 times. There's no segregation in heaven. Mm-mm. Ain't going to be blacks on one side, white, Hispanic. No. We're going to be all people.
Yeah.
So if you got any kind of hatred in your heart, guess what? You are not going to make it into the kingdom of heaven.
Amen.
And we need more love. I ain't talking about that tissue paper love or that pamper love, but the word of God love.
Amen.
That type of love where it'll brace you when you're down, but it'll clock your side of the head when you're wrong.
Amen.
Amen. You know what? This phone should be blowing up like crazy. All these good, great men of God in this word going on. I'm finna call you Pastor Steve.
He's moving up in the world,
he
ain't
moving up. He went from learning the studio, running everything. Minister Steve, teaching us. Now he's going to be Pastor Steve. Get that number one more time.
The number is 803-335-3131. 803-335-3131. And what they're saying is true. It's all about loving people. And when you show that love, you know, people will recognize.
Yes.
People recognize, you know, the ministers that stand out in the crowd.
That's right.
You know, they recognize, you know, when they're having a hard time, somebody's having a good time, and somebody actually loves them and cares about them and actually is trying to preach them and tell them the truth.
I want to go back to the church of the Laodiceans I was dealing with just a while ago. And, of course, Jesus there says, you know, you're lukewarm. You're neither cold nor hot.
Yeah.
And because I despise lukewarm, I'll spew you out of my mouth. And then he goes in verse 19, and this is bouncing off of what RPI was saying here. As many as I love, I rebuke and chasten.
That's right.
Therefore, be zealous and repent. Here's the message for the church. Jesus is saying, I'm coming.
Mm, come on.
And we all agree at this panel that the church is not ready.
That's
how
right.
does the church, who's lukewarm, or maybe like the Ephesian church, absolutely walked off and left their first love, and how do we get back to where we're supposed to be? Jesus says he's rebuking us right now.
Amen.
He's rebuking a hearer right now who's not going to church, who's fussing with the pastor, who's not coming under authority, who's brought division in the home, who's gossiping on the phone. I can go on and on. Y'all, somebody better stop me.
Come on, man.
No, keep going.
So he's saying, you're not where you used to be. You're not where I want you to be. And I'm going to rebuke you. These men's going to put a word on you from my word, and you're going to feel the guilt that God's going to put on you, call you back home. He's going to rebuke you because he loves you. So don't refuse the rebuking of the Lord, the chasing of the Lord, because if you do, it will result in greater punishment.
Yes.
But listen, he says, if we are zealous and repent.
That's right.
Oh, there's the trick.
That repent right there.
That's right.
That fixes everything.
That you got to turn from your wicked ways.
Yes.
Amen. To walk away from. That's what the word, you know, we don't hear repent in the church no more.
Say that again. Say that one more time.
Yeah, we just don't hear that word repent anymore. What does the word mean to repent? The word repent means to turn from.
Mm.
Turn around. Go the other direction. And that's what the word repent means. And nowadays we don't hear that. We hear words like blessings. We hear words like multiplication. We hear words like, you know, cars and houses and lands.
Yeah.
And we hear words about money and owning your own business. But the Lord
said,
this? John the Baptist said, repent.
People are zealous for the blessing. But listen to what Jesus said to be zealous for. If you're in a lukewarm, a cold, backslidden, unrepentative state, Jesus doesn't say go to church seeking a blessing. He says be zealous to repent. Be zealous to repent.
That's right.
Don't just repent a little bit.
Come on.
Be zealous for it. You go at it like you know it's your only salvation.
Amen. That's
because
right.
the truth is, if God doesn't grant you repentance, you will have no salvation.
That's right.
So we have to get back to preaching a powerful message that will bring conviction to the hearts of those that have walked away from God, those that are cold on God, for those that have shut God out of their lives who once had God in their lives, because The church world is right there right now, and Jesus is coming. So I say for those of you that are not really on fire, like you know you should be zealous and repent. That's don't just word. Get on your knees and say, Lord, you know I'm sorry.
Right. Come on.
Get on your knees and pray through again. Get on your knees and then call your pastor and say, I'm sorry, I was working against you in the church. Amen. Get on your Come knees on, and call your neighbor and say, I had aught against you in my heart, but I've forgiven you and preach, I want you to forgive me.
That's
and
right.
you get down, really get down with God and be zealous to repent to a degree Amen. That you can show the world, I am sorry.
Amen.
You know, when they came to John the Baptist, those publicans and sinners
Come
and,
on, talk to
and the other the religious people especially, he said, you bring forth deeds, works, to prove your repentance.
Yes.
That's zealous repentance. Today, we don't preach zealous repentance. We preach just say, I'm sorry, Lord, and
there
be forgiven
go.
And join the church and you'll be saved. Jesus said to these lukewarm people, you better be zealous when you repent.
Amen.
That's right.
But you come here with no half-hearted repentance. You come here with whole heart. And let
That's
me see
good.
Some real truth
That's
in repentance.
Good.
That's right. The Bible say, repent and sin not. Not repent and do it again.
Yeah.
We got a lot of people doing repenting and they keep on sinning. And then we wonder what God is, why God is not moving, because you living in your sin, you living in your mess when you're supposed to repent and do not do that.
Yeah.
And that's one thing I had to learn as a Christian. I remember when I was repent for something I knew I was going to do.
And you did
it. And I did it anyway.
Yeah.
So what was the purpose of doing it? Everything I was doing in vain.
Mm-hmm.
And we get our blessing mixed up. You know, I had ministered a sermon one time where the blessings is, blessings is not the, how can I say it? I say the blessing is not the I'm getting a little tongue twisted here.
Can't help you out because I don't know what you're going for.
Well, anyway,
I get the net, but you got to get the fish up to the top, brother.
I just use that as an example when Peter walked on the water. Well, when people thought that was the blessing. No, that was not the blessing. The blessing is be able to have faith to walk on and know that Jesus Christ was there and he trusted him to walk on the water. The bonus was walking on the water.
Okay.
The blessing to know that Jesus was there and he had enough faith to trust Jesus to walk on the water.
Yeah.
So we get our blessing and bonus mixed up.
Yeah.
You know, the blessing is be able to serve God and know there's a God that you can serve, that you can call on when you're hurting, when you're in sin, when you're on drugs, you can call on Jesus. That's
Amen.
The blessing.
Yes, you can.
The bonus is the healing.
Yeah.
The bonus is God coming into your life and blessing you, you know, and we get it so mixed up in the church. And when I said it, the people looked at me like, okay, what is he talking about? But when I broke it down to him, what it mean by truly being blessed, like the Bible say, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, who shall believe in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. That is a true blessing right there.
Yeah.
The bonus was having an everlasting life because you worship God.
Yeah.
So I tell you, it's just an awesome thing.
Praise God. I like the part where he was talking about, you know, it's, you know, turning. You know, the scripture says, my people that are called by my name.
That's right.
Shall humble themselves. That's the thing. We thing today, nobody want to humble themselves.
Amen.
Everybody wants to be the big shot.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
the big stuff. Who do you think you are? I want to be the big stuff. Mm-hmm. Humble yourself and, you know, and pray. And then turn.
Yeah.
See, a lot of time people are repenting, but they ain't turning.
That's right.
They repent. They saying, you know, the thing they need to say, but they still go out and do the same thing. When you repent, like you said earlier, the repent word means to change. I got to turn. See, if nobody wants to turn. Everybody wants to go to heaven, but nobody don't want to live right.
Yeah.
It's the time we live in. Everybody going to heaven now.
That's
Every
right.
message you hear, you know, nobody going to hell no more.
That's right.
But my understanding, it could probably be more people in hell than in heaven.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen, somebody. So,
many there
you know,
be that go in there.
Thank you. It's a
wide gate.
It's a wide gate. Amen.
Few there be that find that
straight.
Few
going to be
there
find that straight and narrow that walk yeah. there in that. So you know, I want to be sure I'm on my way to heaven.
Amen.
The Bible says, let a man examine himself
That's
daily
right.
and
right.
see whether he be in the faith.
Take
an inventory of your life. Take inventory and see you walking with God. Because in the end, that's the only thing going to mean something. There's two choices God give us. I mean, two choices where you're going to spend eternity at.
Yeah.
And you have to make that choice. You know, thank God that God give us choices.
Amen.
I had a choice to marry my sweet wife. Amen. I could have married somebody else or she could have married somebody else. But we choose to marry each other. But in the end, ain't going to be but two choices that really mean something. Really, really mean something. That's where you spend eternity at.
Amen.
So that's in heaven or in hell.
That's
so we have a choice to make. Amen. And we around this over here around this, in the studio, we made a choice to choose Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Somebody. That's the best that's choice the winning I ever choice. Made.
Amen. 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 He that choose that choice has life.
Amen.
He that don't choose that choice has not life. Yep. And the wrath of God abides on that particular
come on
person
now.
That that's don't right. know Jesus. Amen. So we invested ourselves in something that's going to last forever, and that's eternal life. Mm. Amen.
Amen. I want to say something before we leave the station. The Lord just dropped in my spirit. You know, the Bible says, and we talk about John 3:16, but John 3:17 says, for God sent not his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Mm. I feel like there's listeners out there tonight that that you feel, you know, under condemnation. You feel, but just like the prodigal son, you know, you can always come home.
Come on.
See, that's the thing about God, and that's the thing about Christ. Jesus Christ. He said, while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us.
Yes.
And see, there's a lot of men and a lot of women out there that don't serve God anymore. They brought shame on themselves for they've sinned. But listen, that's the enemy condemning you. That's the devil telling you that God doesn't love you. God's love never changes.
That's right.
You know, God has unconditional love. His love never changes. And whoever you are out there tonight, all you have to do is just what we said.
Yes.
The Bible said to repent. The prodigal son, the Bible said he came to himself. And he said, you know what, in my father's house. And all you got to do is go home. I tell people all the time, listen, backslider, he's right where you left him
Amen.
At.
Amen.
Listen, he's right where he's right where you left him at. You say, but Pastor, you sitting there thinking, you say, Pastor, you don't know where I've been. I don't care where you've been. I don't care how low you are. But we're talking about the coming of the Son of Man. You know Jesus is coming.
Amen.
And you've heard the Bible all your life. You've preached the Bible. You've stood on the Word of God. And now you're out in the world. And you said, yeah, but the church ain't going to accept me. Listen, the church don't have to accept you. It's Jesus that accepts you.
Amen.
It's God
Amen.
That forgives.
That's right.
Amen.
So you trust the Lord and say, Lord, come into my life. Lord, change me. Lord, wash me. Start afresh. Start anew. And I promise you, God himself will come in and sup with you, and he'll be your friend, and he'll love you. Put his arms around you, because God's love.
Amen.
Amen. God's love is all that matters. Oh, and so repent. Whoever's out there listening to me, I just feel it in my heart. Listen, preacher, you may have walked away, but God never left you.
Amen.
And all you got to do is say, Lord, I'm sorry.
Amen.
Come home. Come home. Come home, because the Lord's waiting on you.
Praise God.
Amen. Yeah, you know, in the last part of the church that John was instructed by God to write to there, the Laodiceans, he did say, I stand at the door and knock. That's Christ.
Yes.
I'm knocking. So I know that right now some listeners are feeling that same knock that the Laodiceans heard when Jesus said, I'm standing at the door. And all you got to do is open that door. And he said, I will come in.
Mm.
All you got to do is open the door. That's how simple it is. Just let Jesus back in your life.
Amen.
Let him back in your circumstances, and he'll take care of the rest. But if you keep him outside that door, he can't do nothing for you.
That's right.
He's on the outside wanting to come,
come in. Come
you
on,
you on the inside needing to get out.
Amen. He said the Bible said he's married to the backslider.
Yes, he is.
And he's married to you. He wants you to come home today.
Amen. So what a good way to close our program.
Amen. Amen.
We just got a minute, and we're going to have to close this thing out. Brother RPI, you're going to get ready to do the switchboard for us. Tell everybody goodbye before you go.
Goodbye.
That's RPI, my co-host for the show. Love that young man right there. He's come a long way. God has sent him to me a year or so ago, maybe going on 2 years now, and God's really done a great work through him. I appreciate Brother and Minister Steve here at the controls. God's bringing him a long way.
Amen.
He was named after me, for those of you who don't know. Me and his daddy's been close friends for a long time, and when we found that he was the bun that was in the oven, his daddy said, if it's a boy, he's going to carry your name. And so he gave him my name, and I'm glad to have him here in the studio working with me today.
Amen. It's always a blessing being here and just speaking the word of God and letting people know that we love them and we want to see them in heaven too.
Amen.
And it's been great to have Pastor Banks with us. Thanks for coming again, Pastor
God
Banks.
Bless you, Pastor Steve. I enjoy myself.
And Pastor Farmer, it's been a great privilege to meet you today and to have you here on the show.
Amen. It's been good to be here. May the Lord bless you and
Amen.
Keep you.
Amen.
So
Amen.
We want to thank our listening audience again for tuning in. And you have been listening to 99.9 WUCC. And God has a special plan for you. And, Brother RPI just comes running in telling me, don't forget to remind you of the rebroadcast that is tomorrow between 2 and 3. But if you're listening to the rebroadcast, you won't hear this announcement until it's too late. So anyway, for those of you that are listening now, you can listen again between 2 and 3 tomorrow. And thank you for listening to 99.9 WCC. I've been the host for the show. I'm Steve Hall. I'm the pastor of the Johnston Church of God. And let me tell you, the men in this meeting tonight here around the round table, we love you. God loves you. Why don't you come home to Jesus?
Amen.
And if you're home with Jesus, why don't you dig in, pull your seat up to the table? God's got a great banquet spread
Amen.
For you.
Amen.
Thank
Amen.
You for listening. We love you to life. We're going to return you now to our regular scheduled broadcasting.
Amen. Praise God.